Good morning, and welcome to the celebration of life for Nick. We pray in thanksgiving for God's blessings for all of us, for the family gathering faith, and we ask the Lord to bless all of us on this day as we honor his memory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, Nick died with Christ and rose with him to a new life. May he now share with him in eternal glory. Nick was clothed with a white garment at the moment of baptism. Today, we also ask the Lord to embrace him into everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Nick, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Please be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet if they're hopeful of immortality, chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over people, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Not A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. Love is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly, as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully, as I am fully known. So, faith, hope, love remain these three. But the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia,
alleluia. Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, my disciples are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known, that the love with which you love me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be. Please be seated for a few moments. I would like to welcome all of you to this celebration. We know that we come from different places, different backgrounds, and if you are here from the city of Winter Park, I would like to welcome you also. Where our friend Nick work, you know, right? Is that correct? As you mentioned that in the, and also
those of you who are here maybe from Rollins College or any other places, you know, where our friend Nick was able to work and do his life. When we come to a funeral like this, to a place in a church, to a place where we know we can find consolation, it is also a place where we come to ask the Lord questions. I hope that you have a lot of questions in your mind, don't you? We do have a lot of questions in our minds today, you know, to see Nick's life for all these 12 years, you know, being taken care of by the family, and also the love that you showed to him all these years. You know, I had the opportunity to visit him before he died, you know, and I was really impressed by the way that you care for him, that you love him. He was just comfortable and there's, you know, in bed, and we were able to pray with him and commend his soul to the Lord. And it is so nice to see that there are family members who care for each other. And I know you are a very close family, and I'm going to pray for all of you, because this is going to be a very difficult moment to have Nick in front of you every single day for all these years, and now he's gone. He's gone to the Father, and he's going to be put into rest later on in life. He's going to be taken up to a place with the family. So let us be reminded today, first, of the love of God for us, for the family who is mourning today, who is able to acknowledge that God has been with them all these years. It is amazing to know that we are going to do this funeral. We are doing this funeral on the 12th of January. Huh? And I know he was sick for about 12 years, you know, so it's amazing. You know, the Lord gave us the January 12th, you know, this day, in which we know also the same years that he was, you know, taking care by the family. We know also his mantra, the way that he was able to tell his father all the time. I would probably say to mom also, right? The mantra that he will share with the family: no retreat, no surrender, here I stand. So that's going to be in your hearts. He was able to say that, and probably every day. I don't know, how often did he say that to you? Many times, probably, yeah. And he was ready to fight. He was ready to stand up, and here I stand. So I think for all of us, that's a great example of courage, to be able to know that even though he was in a very limited situation, he was able to be in this good attitude. He loved his two brothers, his niece and nephew, his many friends, animals, and especially the sea turtles he swam with in Hawaii. Huh? That was the way that he enjoyed his life. He was Jesuit educated, attended Rollins College, majored in environmental sciences, and worked in administration in the city of Winter Park. These are all the accomplishments that we have from our friend Nick, and in such a young age, 45, no? He was able to do a lot of things, not only for the people that he cared, that he loved, but also for himself. Well, you can also go through the main door. Before you go out, there are stairs that you can go through and be able to be connected to the parish hall. Or you can go also through the outside and make a left immediately, and you will be connected to the doors in the front. Well, that would mean the back of the building. So I invite you today to experience this great love of God for all of us. Like the family here was able to give that love to Nick for all these years, we also are invited today to share the love of God and to experience that love through Jesus, through our faith, through our commitment to one another. We are here today because of the love of God, because of the love of Jesus. And I know that Nick will be very happy if we were to speak today about the great love that the family shared with him. May the Lord grant him eternal rest. May the Lord give him the peace and the reconciliation that he needs today. And may the Lord give to all the family, to all of us, the same consolation, the same love, and the same forgiveness that we are able to experience through this gospel of today. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
Please rise as we will continue with the prayers of intercession. We are going to pray right now for our friend Nick and for all of you, the family and the friends who are gathered in faith. My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Nick received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
Lord, have mercy.
Our brother Nick was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
The family and friends of Nick seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we will continue with the service.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your where there's despair in life, let me bring hope.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the all his church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Nick, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this early dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
I invite you at this time, please, to sit or kneel. Thank you. You are holy indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May holy, therefore, this case we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pope Francis and John, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please stand again as we will continue with the communion rite. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be always with you. Let us offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Please stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, grant mercifully that, strengthened by it, our brother Nick may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. We are going to invite the family now to write the name of Nick into the book of the living here in our church, and we will be praying for him every week, okay? Yes, my pleasure. This is his name and the date of that. When he died. The last part of our service today will be the commendation of his soul to the Lord, and it will be followed by a song. So I invite you please to see that on your pews. There's going to be a little blue card that you can follow with, and we can all together sing the commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Nick, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed to human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As you are aware, we have a little reception downstairs in our parish hall, and you are all invited to participate. At this moment, we would like you to come forward and greet the family, and you can go through these two doors going downstairs or through the elevator if you are not able to walk through the stairs, and you can also go to the front of the church and make a left and you will find the place, okay? Anybody needs directions? It's going to be easy, right? Just one floor down. That's good. So thank you for being with us today. I know the family will be very happy to be with you for a few moments and a little refreshment, and you're all invited to be here, okay? Anything else for the family, for people here today? So we will see you downstairs, okay? And thank you for everything. Thank you for the opportunity to give me to visit Nick before he died, you know, and for all of you, this is really a peaceful moment, okay? God bless you.